Jerry Lane Enterprises and Courtesy Motors present Paradise, Louisiana. With Gary Risponi and Don DeBute. Paradise, Louisiana is also brought to you by Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company, Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change, Always Fresh, Never Frozen Raising Cane's, Louisiana Fish Fry Products, Demco, your Touchstone Energy Cooperative, Pro Drive Outboards, Blue Cross Blue Shield of Louisiana, and Rouse's Markets. You're either local or you're not.
Welcome to this week's edition of Paradise, Louisiana. I'm Gary Risponi, and I'm in a recovery mode. Don, this is more than recovery, huh?
A good timing that this Rouse's store in Baton Rouge opened up to kind of fill in some problems they're having at the Jubin Road store until that one gets back up and running, gives the local people as just as good, but an alternative place to shop.
Oh, yeah, and it's sort of in the same location. When you walk in, you think you're in Jubin Road. So, Don, I had another busy weekend. You did also. My weekend consisted of finally getting to shoot some teal. Got up early Sunday morning, and I went to Doug's Hunting Lodge. And I made the trip over there. And Doug, I'm gonna tell you, Don, I'm gonna reiterate one more time. If you wanna make a good duck hunt, teal hunt, they have openings now. They had a lot of their regulars, everybody killed Saturday morning. And that's one reason I was over there Sunday morning. And I'm sure you got, in the hunting report, you got some stories too, the difference between one day to the next.
Right.
And that's the way it is. And sometimes during the week, there's not enough people shooting, but we had a 16-day season coming up. You can call Doug right now and get in on some teal, but especially in the big duck seasons coming up, he's down the bookings because of the oil companies. Oil companies are not booking, they're saving money, oil
exactly.
Prices going up and down. You'll miss a great opportunity if you like to hunt. One of the better places, you know, all over the state, you got a good duck season there. They're the most consistent club in this area. That was in the Southwest. So please call Doug. Tell him Gary Risponi, Don DeBute sent you.
Well, I had a busy hunting week, too. In fact, the last couple of weeks, I went out to a place called Running Creek Ranch in Poplarville on opening weekend. Shot a limit of doves there. Had some really good action from the doves. Went this past weekend again to Poplarville, different place. Went to one of the places where we hunt a lot of quail, Crane Creek Hunting Preserve. Got another limit of doves there. Had my buddy Jerry Cross came along, Carl Beyer with his dog Annie, Craig Lucker, a lot of the oldies but goodies, and had a great hunt there. Teal season, like you said, and we'll talk more about it in the hunting report, was two different days. Saturday and Sunday, completely different hunts and adventures that people went on, so we'll talk about that. And I got to fish with one of my favorite fishing buddies, Captain Deadly Dudley Vandenboer. And we're kind of in that transition period. We're moving away from summer, getting into early fall. Trout are hard to catch. We show you how to make up a different type of catch by getting some of those lesser-known species and making a mixed bag.
And I want to tell you, you make me envious every time you fish with Dudley, because one of my favorite trips. And first time I went fishing with you, you took me on a trip with Deadly Dudley. But he is always doing things for keeper. In a couple of weeks, I think on the 21st, 22nd, we're going to be with Dudley. I'm going to be shooting camera. I don't know if I'm going to be fishing, but we have some autistic kids. There's another Trinity Outdoor deal coming up. So we look forward to that coming up. I also, you know, when I went to the Duck Festival, we showcased them. It was so many days that we were there, you know, and covering everything. We gave you the benefit and showed you all the festivities.
Mm-hmm.
But the main reason was the Duck and Goose Calling Championships are named every year, and the famous dog trial. So we're going to bring you a little bit more, especially the goose. Nathan Fleming has been winning trophies all over. We came in second in the duck calling contest, but we did an interview with the goose champions, and there's some young people over there that right now growing up. And by the way, he's winning. He came in second in the world in goose calling championship in Katy, Texas. And this kid ain't but 18 years old. So
outstanding.
Imagine what's coming. And you've seen all the articles about the young duck callers, you introduced us to, so.
Miles Pond,
We got more coming up. We got a lot of news coming up, items. Don, I'm going to let you talk about this because you talked about it on the radio. They had a meeting last Wednesday. We mentioned it on the show. Stay tuned this week. We'll bring you some more news. It's not clearing up. What do you think? We're going to
Well, I would call this trouble in paradise. Sportsman's Paradise. There's a lot of problems at our Louisiana Department of Wildlife and Fisheries that I think is getting in the way of them doing their job. We also got some serious updates on the chronic wasting disease ban that was brought up. There's been some developments there for you deer hunters. You won't want to miss that. Plus the Berkeley Abu Garcia Fishing Report. It's all coming up right here on Paradise, Louisiana.
Hope, the want, desire, or expectation of something to happen. Hope is what's left when all else is gone. Hope is the idea that we can be made whole again. Hope is being able to see that there is light despite all of the darkness. As I watch the devastation of the second 100-year flood in 5 months, I'm begging myself to come up with comforting words. I'm sorry, I don't have any. I don't have any clever phrases or stories of my children to make what was destroyed whole again. What I have is hope. What we all have, what we need to have, is hope. I watched a news report soon after the waters rose where a woman stated she had no hope. I can't believe that. One cannot run out of hope. Hope is limitless. You can create it out of nothing. It is real. And it is powerful. Moreover, hope gives those that have hope agency. That's the simple belief that you can indeed succeed. You have hope. Better yet, hope is physical. If you have it, you can withstand pain. I mean literally withstand pain. The simple act of hope has true physical and emotional properties. I was looking over Facebook posts, and time again, people were writing, "I'm praying for you. Prayers are coming your way, thinking of you." I've seen people argue in the past, you know, what good is that gonna do? Well, comfort for one, support for another, hope. In the aftermath, the outpouring of aid and assistance and giving from those that have to those that do not is reassuring. That simple act of giving or receiving can help you heal, both mentally and physically. Now, simply sitting and waiting for something to happen by miracle is not hope. Hope, true hope, is coupled with action. And the research shows that the hopeful are much more interested in actually doing the work because they believe it will achieve goals. They're hopeful. This is a difficult time. As the state moves forward, my family and I wish you well and wish you safe. We will come through this. We have hope.
Courtesy Automotive is one of the largest and most experienced automotive groups in the South. Courtesy is the clear choice for all your automotive needs. So whether you're looking for a Ford, a Chevrolet, a Ram, Toyota, or a GMC, Courtesy's got your truck.
A big truck, a small truck, Courtesy's got your truck, man.
Ask me about my Tempur-Pedic.
Ask me how fast I fall asleep.
Why not talk to someone who's sleeping on the most highly recommended bed in America?
Ask me about staying asleep.
Tempur-Pedic owners are more satisfied than owners of any traditional mattress brand.
Ask me how it feels after 10 years.
Tempur-Pedic, the most highly recommended bed in America.
Ask about Tempur-Pedic at Olin's, where you know you always get the guaranteed low price.
Olin's is the only store in Baton Rouge and Lafayette with the full line of Tempur-Pedics.
Welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana. And Gary, I want you to pay particular attention to this segment because you are now in this area where we fish. You got your camp out on the Wrigley's on Salt Bayou. That's where we fish with Captain Deadly Dudley, offering some tips when the trout aren't participating that great. And there's times of the year when trout fishing is off, there's some alternatives to help save your trip. We left out of Wrigley's Marina, got some live bait, went down the Wrigley's to the east, stopped at a place a lot of people know, Polecat Bend is what they call it. It's on the shoreline, fishing with popping corks. Didn't really have a lot of tide movement. Saw a lot of bait, a lot of shrimp boats. The area looked right and caught some speckled trout, mostly undersized trout. Did find a few keepers there. Along that shoreline, you can pick up some redfish. Nice flounder. Dudley landed one of the first fish we caught was a pretty flounder. Then when he saw the tide starting to stop and get ready to fall, he said it's time to head to that Wrigley's Railroad Bridge. So he went there. It's a real popular fishing spot. You've seen us fish there before. Got up on the fender well, switched over to Carolina rig, put the live shrimp down on the bottom. Bob Delaney was along with us, caught some nice reds, caught a puppy drum. Speckled trout got a little bigger there. We managed to catch some that were keepers. One problem you're going to have, you get 200 baits, 150 baits, those croakers right now, the little croaker are going to eat your bait up. You got hard heads you're dealing with, you're dealing with the gaff tops. And so what Dudley does is when he sees that happening, he takes one of his straight-tailed Dudleys, rigs it Carolina rig on his hook, and sends it down there.
Straight-tail, no tail. Swim.
That's right, and he'll send them down there and keep that's a lot of that
trash. That's because of those sand eels and stuff. That's what it is. Most popular bait when it first came out.
It was.
Because of the type of bait that were at the bridges.
The straight tail was his favorite bait, but it became easier with the paddle tail because it put more automatic motion in it, and the average fisherman could work a little better, where working that one with the straight tail
what
required
color?
A little
what
more.
What color was it?
It was like a bone color, bone color. You'll see it here. We'll take it in now. Captain Deadly Dudley, and we're fishing the Wrigley's for a mixed bag. Speckled trout, redfish, flounder. It's all happening as we make the transition from summer to early fall.
Yeah, we're about 3 weeks away from them, but it's one of the kind of days you go out, you're going to catch 20, 15 fish, you know, and it's going to be a mixture of fish, redfish, speckled trout, flounders, a few sheephead on occasions, and a few drums. You go on the shoreline and throw corks early in the morning, and as the day goes by, go into that deeper water because they'll migrate back to it. Try to catch a change in the tide. When the tide slows down, they'll bite. You know, get in someplace in the pass or someplace in deep water.
Decent trout there, huh?
Well, when you're on the shoreline, you want a lot of tide. But when you get in the pass, you want less tide. So, you know, if you go out in the morning and it got a lot of tide running, go to the shoreline, work a shoreline with a cork, you'll catch a little mixed bag of fish. And then go into the passes, you know, whether it's here, Chef Pass, Seabrook Bridge, you know, the Wrigley's. You know, Wrigley's is just starting to get some trout moving through it, and it's just going to get better.
Oh, a little puppy drum. All right, we'll add puppy drum to our list of fish.
Yeah, I think we're about 3 weeks away from being steady and then probably 4 to 5 weeks away from being good. So, you know, it's real close to us. You'll see a little better. It'll get a little better almost every day now.
Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change has been keeping cars and trucks in Baton Rouge clean and running smooth for over 50 years. At Benny's, we feature professional car washing, complete detailing, high-tech waxing and buffing, interior cleaning, and tire shine. Benny's, one stop for car maintenance with complete oil and lube services and even state inspections at our express locations. Visit one of our 5 convenient locations, including our newest store on Greenwell Springs Road. And don't forget to stop by Be Quick Convenience Store and Fuel Stop. Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change. Drive in dirty, drive out clean.
Dove hunting on opening day and listening to LSU football. And you're watching Paradise, Louisiana.
Box combo, please.
At Raising Cane's, we do one thing. We do it better than anyone else. So why not let our food do the talking?
Love in the window.
Raising Cane's, only the best chicken finger meals. One love.
Welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana. Gary, keel hunting got underway this past weekend, and we'll talk more about the numbers and how one day to the next were totally different days. I got to make that second day trip with Ryan Lambert down in Burris. They struggled a little bit on the first day, but the group had 37 teal, pretty respectable, had some good action. Saw a lot of birds migrating in. Action picked up in some of the other areas too. And I'm going to plan on getting out there again this week. Now, you went down to Doug's down on the Klondike,
right.
Southwestern Louisiana.
The reason I went southwest, I called my brother Jerry. I own a report. We were all at Wednesday, Friday night, and everybody was getting up and coming back for LSU game. So that's a two-hour trip. And so if you're going to make that shooting time 6 o'clock, you know, you got to get up about 2:30, 3 o'clock, and you go. And everybody's making those one-day trips. That's how exciting my family gets. On deer, you ain't got to bring a dog, especially in the marsh.
Right.
Mr. Doug told me, do not bring a dog right now, the alligators. And we proved out pretty good about what he was saying was true, because a couple of alligators got that limit too. So, I mean, before we could get in the P-Row and get out there without a dog,
yeah. They
got them. But let me tell you about Doug Lennon. They've been in so business so long. The groups come in, most of them spend the night. You wake up in the morning, you got snacks, and get you all ready. You got your coffee. You go in the blind, you're either gonna go in the rice field or in the marsh. The marsh is all mud buddy type boats. I mean, the goat devils and pro drives and gate. You know, they hand these guys, they go out, their guides are there. My guide was a 22-year-old boy. I'm gonna introduce you to him. I did all the interviews with him. His name was Jacob Sloan. Jacob was raised in that area. He went to Notre Dame with Crowley, played football, he worked in the oil field. But he'd been hunting since he was a little bitty boy. He blows that teal call, he blows a goose call, and he's also waiting on duck season. He said Doug's right now in that area. Doug's is the premier place. The food is outstanding. They got a soft ice cream machine. When you get in that brunch, you believe in brunch? I guess why they call it brunch. I was used for breakfast. You know, you got eggs and grits and everything you can imagine. Biscuits, gravy, even oatmeal for people that want to be healthy. Yeah, bacon, ham. I looked over there. They had a big pot, and they had rice. I looked over there.
Instead of the phrase "kid in a candy store," maybe we need to change this to Gary at a breakfast buffet. Huh?
Oh, I'll tell you what. I was starving because I drove all the way there.
I understand.
But look, I'm trying to sell you on Doug's hunting life. They got a lot of opening. And if you call it brown nosing, you call it what it wanted, but it's the truth.
Tough hunt or hunt for kids, ladies?
Everything. Anybody you want to bring your kids, it's a great hunt. Get in the boat, they put you out in the blind. You ain't got to walk, you ain't got to do nothing. You know, in the rice fields, the same way, they bring you right up to the blind. Older, they got handicap accessible stuff. So I just want to talk about it. But here we go again. We with Jacob Sloan, Doug's Hunting Lodge in Klondike, Louisiana.
Welcome to Doug's Hunting Lodge. I'm Jacob Sloan. I'll be these fellas' guides today. We have a marsh out here, hunting in the marsh. Good vegetation, great for ducks. So we'll see what today brings.
Ha ha ha!
A lot better, boss. Is that cherubis hunting back there? That's that song.
I think that's one.
Y'all won't notice, but when you see all the birds that were flying and all the flights this morning and all the missing, I wouldn't shoot. I just picked my gun up and now they're starting to die a little bit. I made a few shots and killed a few, but I've been on camera. We got a GoPro working. I don't know what it's recovering, but you just get tired of seeing them flying and missing and going away. They're doing a great job, though. This marsh is a lot different, and what's really different, it reminds me of being below Amelia and Deer Island by, and then when I used to hunt with Jody, because early in the year, you don't want to bring your dog. If you do, you put him in the boat with you, and you go find him later. But alligator, a little alligator, I got two ducks already, and Mike going to get three. If it wouldn't be for Jacob out there in that P-row, we'd probably lose more than that. The marsh is full of alligators. We're just south. Klondike, Louisiana.
Well, I'm from Crowley, Louisiana. I graduated from Notre Dame High School in 2012. I've been guiding for about 3 years in the marsh. I have a few friends that guide out here. That's how I got hooked up with this. I have a buddy, Isaac, the other guide.
Okay.
I used to have a few other friends that guided for him. So I've heard of this place for a long time, pretty much my whole life. It's a good place. Produces a lot of birds in the duck season too. A lot of speckled bellies too. It's just all around a great place. Great hospitality, great food, cooking. You know, they give you places to stay, nice beds and everything. It's just an all around place.
So what's your favorite? Teal season, duck season, speckled belly? Which one?
Well, duck season is always, the big duck season is always my favorite. But I just started, I picked up speck hunting about 2 or 3 years ago, and I'm starting to like that a little bit more, but I still love killing them greenheads.
I don't blame.
Goodbye! Starting out, for the people in the Southwest, it's starting out to be a good year, especially for teal. A lot of water. You've seen that coming in. What makes it so great, I got my grandson with me. I got to meet a new guy, a new person, and it's a good start. Everybody killed yesterday. We killed today. We got our limit, finally, about 8:30 right now, and it's starting to get warm. So stay tuned for more Paradise, Louisiana. When we get back to the lodge, we're going to see what the other guys did.
This is Don Dubuque asking you to join me as a member of the Coastal Conservation Association. For 30 years, CCA has worked in Louisiana to conserve our incredible fisheries, making sure that our fishing is great today and for generations to come. Whether looking out for redfish and specks, eliminating gill nets, building reefs across the coast, or work at the state capitol and in D.C., CCA is doing what's best for the fish and the sport we love so much. Your $30 membership will ensure that this work and our great fishing endures well into the future. Go to CCALouisiana.com and join CCA today.
Stay tuned for more Paradise, Louisiana.
Hi, I'm John Jackson, and you know we always say we gather our groceries out the bayou. Whether it's freshwater, saltwater, catfish, redfish, you have tons of choices when it comes to fish in Louisiana. But when I fry fish, there's only one choice, and that's Louisiana Fish Fry. My new favorite, the Cajun Fish Fry, has the perfect amount of cornmeal, corn flour, and the perfect mix of spices that really bring the heat. Hey, if you're craving Cajun, go look for the bright red bag at your local grocers. Bring home the taste of Louisiana with Louisiana Fish Fry.
To the 2016 Goose and Duck Festival here in Gaydon, Louisiana. The Louisiana Junior State Champion, William Barnes. William, not only did you won the state championship, you won the Open Division too. Tremendous. I got many questions. I watched your family watch you the whole time. I'm blown away with how many junior callers are great. You had a lot of competition. You walk away with both winners. Who's the one person in your life you attribute teaching you the most or the biggest influence in Special Better College?
Probably my brother.
Your brother?
My brother, Jacob Barnes. He was also calling in the contest as well.
Do a lot of Special Better College?
Yes, sir.
Hunting? Yes. Where you hunting?
I hunt in Bunker, Louisiana. It's near Markville.
Y'all had a good year last year? You looking forward to this year? Where you go to school?
Sacred Heart High School.
You play any other sport?
Mostly I just run track and cross country.
That's the sport. Congratulations to you. This is a big honor because I watch the competition all day. William Bourne, state champion, Speckle Belly Call. Story with Nathan Fleming. When the first time he won, not only did we mess up the interview, we had bad audio, but we talked about it from then on out. But he went to Stuttgart and he won the World Intermediate Championship, correct?
Yes, sir.
Since then, he's been winning championships every year. You can see this year, he's the state speckled belly champion, senior. He's also the open collar champion. He went in championships all along. Last year, he came in second in the world in Speckled Belly Calling.
This year. Yeah.
This year, he just came back from Katy, Texas.
From Katy, Texas.
And he was second in the world. Now, you going to be headed anywhere from here? Where are you going?
I'm pretty much done for the year. I might do a little. I thought about traveling because I got second in the state duck calling today. I was really focused on it. I had a chance to win. And didn't work out the way I wanted. I may travel to do a regional to see if I can punch a ticket to go to Stuttgart in the duck, but I'll probably just hang around here and just hunt for it.
Well, you ain't gonna be hanging around right now. We got seasons coming up. We're starting with teal season here in about 2 weeks, and then you got the duck season. You've guided now. You've been guiding since you was a sophomore in high school, correct?
Yes, sir.
Southwest Louisiana?
Sportsman. Yes, sir.
That's a lodge? Where
yes, sir.
Is that?
It's
Thornwell?
Thornwell, just outside of Lake Arthur, Louisiana. This is the third or fourth year it's been running. We got five-star lodge, really good hunting property, and good meals, everything you can.
Thornwell has been historically really known for geese. I hunted there a lot 20 years ago. Vendetta is the call you use?
Yes, sir. Vendetta Waterfowl.
Right. I'm just going to tell you, congratulations. I apologize to you for 3 years ago. 4 years ago, 18 years old, and he got a lot of respect. He's coaching and teaching too. A lot of kids right now. I asked him, him and Nick,
Garrett.
They're all taking these kids under their wing and coaching them. So you see these young kids. I got excerpts of the juniors calling all week. You will not believe how good. If you don't see them up there, if you just listen to them, you think they were seniors. So I want to thank Kelsey Bim on the camera right now. Her and her dad is the one got me started in this thing, Phil McDaniel. So thank you one more time for being patient, hanging around.
Yes, sir.
All your fans out there waiting on you. If you've never been to the Gate on Duck Festival, you're missing one of the events in your life. This is the 40th annual. Glad to be here. Sorry to be by myself. I would maybe a little bit better with a mic, but I've already scheduled a hunt with y'all.
Yeah.
And I told them you had to be calling. So
sounds good.
Stay tuned more to Paradise, Louisiana. We're going to be hunting in Thornwell. Nathan Fleming. Took me 3 years to remember his last name. Thank you, Nathan.
Yes, sir.
Congratulations. First weekend of tail season. You watching Paradise, Louisiana.
Welcome to the Flambeau Outdoor News segment of Paradise, Louisiana. Gary, the biggest news going on. We got trouble in Sportsman's Paradise over at Louisiana Department of Wildlife and Fisheries. A lot of controversy going on over there. The commission members are refusing to validate and approve the minutes from the July and August meetings based on the assumption that somebody went in there and changed the minutes. Then we had a Watergate-style break-in, a burglary, went in and stole a hard drive from an employee who was a stenographer. She got fired, no reason why, they're not talking. She's lawyered up. The commission, the department employees are lawyered up. Nobody's saying anything about what's going on, but we know there is trouble brewing. It all kind of gets back to this red snapper debacle that's been going on. There's been name-calling between Secretary Malonson calling Congressman Garrett Graves Pinocchio, and he's denying it. And it's just a big mess, and it's really become a big distraction for the Department of Wildlife and Fisheries from accomplishing
and
their
mission.
And
all those sportsmen around the state. You know, it's looking like that. Here we are, supposed to be, after all the floods and stuff going here and there. And I heard your editorial on Saturday morning on the paper, and you saying it's time for the governor. You know, let's give him a chance, because he's done handled all the killing, what's going on.
He's been a busy guy.
He's been over there. He's handling this flood like that. He's been to Washington.
State budget.
Why? You know, it's a shame. You're right. He's probably going to have to handle this. He's going to have to take the bull by the horns and go in there and
well,
say, okay.
When he ran, if you remember, his campaign was he's got military leadership. He's got a code of honor, ethics. Let's see it. This is the perfect opportunity to step in and clear up what's going on in your agency, Department of Wildlife and Fisheries.
I trust him. I think he will. And I might be wrong, you see, but I think you look around. I think John Bell's going to come through with that military experience he's going to say, because I didn't want to take fun away from him on the dove hunt.
Yeah.
But you can tell he is always listening. He's a people person. Might not think the way everybody in the state is, we know. Everybody's supposed to be a Republican state, a Democrat state, and I told you, I've been a no-party guy, and give everybody in the building a chance. Let's give him a chance and let's see what happens. And please come through, John Bell, because this is a serious matter right now with sportsmen, all your conservation groups, they're holding back. You say what they want about Robert Barnum, he brought everybody together. Legislators, he was one of the better ones. And we have had some great wildlife and fishing
Well, in the 30-plus years I've been covering this agency, I've never seen it with all the controversy, disarray, and behind-the-doors dealing that's going on. It's time it stops. All right, let's move
on. Lifetime employees, too. Everybody over there right now, they did all the great work. They scared. Even them other people, they said, you know, we'll talk. We're going to get fired. You know, they might be eligible for retirement, and they'll go might speak up. But somebody over there knows what's going on. Maybe Todd's writing articles. Maybe we can get Todd. Do you think we get Todd on?
He might come on and talk. He's got some anonymous sources that have been filling him in on some of the stuff going on. It's leaking out. That's the way it goes.
Stay tuned. Anybody want to make a rebuttal? Comment. Get in touch with me. Either side, you let me know. We'll give you a chance to come on.
Another big issue in the news has been the proposed importation ban on whitetail deer and other cervids into the state of Louisiana. Deer hunters have been in opposition to this. There's a lot of problems with it with regard to bringing animals into the state, to the taxidermists, to the processes. It's going to be a hardship. I want to make it clear that at the last commission meeting, they voted to postpone any changes until next season. Nothing is going to change for this season, but that doesn't mean the discussion is not going to continue on how to get these animals in, keep our taxidermist industry vital and healthy.
They did the present. Didn't they refine what was
They've changed some on bringing the carcasses in. You can bring some of the quarters in now because Texas was not going to allow it to be deboned and leaving the state. Some things have been resolved, but there's a lot of things that have not been resolved. Got from now until next year to do it. So rest assured, if you're a deer hunter, no changes until next year with regard to that.
And speak out.
And learn more about CWD. It's an insidious disease. It's really a threat. I was looking at some research last week where they did an 8-year study, and some biologists are actually predicting that within 50 years, the white-tailed deer could become totally extinct due to this. I don't personally believe that, but that's one of the conclusions that some of these scientists drew about how bad this disease is.
You know, everybody talk about doomsday advocates, and they don't believe in global warming, but yet we here. We got a 1,000-year flood here. Sometimes they wonder, and some of our people blame it on global warming. I don't know. They say global warming. Last year we had one of the coldest winters around. Did you realize Louisiana right now has almost doubled our average? No, I take away. I'm wrong. We're at 70-something inches of rain in this area right now already. And the year ain't over. We're supposed to have a dry month in October coming up, but you realize our average rainfall is in around 50-something feet. You know what, we're over
inches.
70.
It's average about 60 inches, and we're about 10 over it already. So, yeah, it's been obviously unusual, heavily rain. The last thing I want to talk about, this is your baby. You've been talking with me about this for years, National Hunting and Fishing Day in Louisiana. It's a great celebration. We've gone and covered the one at Wadeel and some at Woodworth all through the years. The one in Baton Rouge is going to be canceled this year. Obviously, there's too much damage at Wadeel, the site. They can't pull it off. But the question becomes, we've talked about, why doesn't the city of New Orleans get a celebration for their residents there? They've been neglected now for years. This maybe, if any year, would be the opportunity to put the resources that they've got to work in the New Orleans area, since there's not going to be one
what
in Baton Rouge.
So complicated to me, and why I don't understand is because, number one, Danica Williams and all that group, education group, the Fish Fest have been so popular, they're going all over the state, they keep expanding, they're doing this. On the Hunting and Fishing Day, it's been popular. The largest crowds ever, Woodworth, Baton Rouge, Monroe, West Monroe, they bring the people, Halton, middle small town. Mm-hmm. Now, in Lake Charles, St. Bernard to them, Destrehan, the conservation groups have Green Wing Days, and they've been very successful in doing it. Got some coming up, you see on the calendar. Don, I agree with you, heard me say it. New Orleans, get off your butt. Wildlife and Fishing, go to New Orleans. They got City Park, they got so many places close to you right there. Right now,
Lafreniere Park.
This time of year, the Bonacare Spillway is just between everything over there in that area. You can go to Bonacare Spillway, set up tents, set up whatever. Great opportunity. They got fishing, they got the little ponds over there. Great opportunity. Remember, Don Dubuque said, get off your butt. Get off your butt.
All right, we'll be right back with the Berkeley Abu Garcia Fishing Report coming up right here on Paradise, Louisiana.
Curtis has got your truck, man's so get yourself a deal, man.
Courtesy Automotive is one of the largest and most experienced automotive groups in the South. Courtesy is a clear choice for all your automotive needs. So whether you're looking for a Ford, a Chevrolet, a Ram, Toyota, or a GMC, Courtesy's got your truck.
A big truck, a small truck, Courtesy's got your truck, man.
Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change has been keeping cars and trucks in Baton Rouge clean and running smooth for over 50 years. At Benny's, we feature professional car washing, complete detailing, high-tech waxing and buffing, interior cleaning, and tire shine. Benny's, one stop for car maintenance with complete oil and lube services and even state inspections at our express locations. Visit one of our five convenient locations, including our newest store on Greenwell Springs Road. And don't forget to stop by Be Quick Convenience Store and Fuel Stop. Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change. Drive in dirty, drive out clean.
Welcome back to the Paradise, Louisiana Hunting Report. Gary, going back to the dove season opening, I had an excellent hunt, Running Creek Ranch. I had one hunt was canceled. This one presented an opportunity. It's in Poplarville, Mississippi. The preparation of the field was done in a couple of ways. It was really well prepared. There was some sunflowers that were burned, and the doves just poured into that burned hillside. We also had some top seeding that was going on between some soybean patches, all legal. And what a hunt it was. It was great. We had a little bit of a cloud cover and some wind came up that Saturday. And when that did, boy, the birds really got crazy. And most people, if you could shoot, got their limit that day. This past weekend, the hunt that was canceled in Poplarville at Crane Creek went on. The birds actually had showed up in the meantime. Another great hunt. All that bad weather that hit Baton Rouge and postponed the start of the LSU game. Never touched Poplarville. We did have some good, even cloud cover, which made it really nice. A little breeze blowing. I had a perfect setup, put some robos out underneath an old dead tree. And it took a while. There was about an hour and a half shooting going on. I wasn't in the action. But then it kind of moved my way and got my limit in no time. Picked up one of those.
That must mean you shot well.
Well, yeah, I did. Actually, I did. And I had one of those bonus birds, those big Eurasians, and we'll show you the difference in the size. Like looking like a big pigeon with a square tail compared to a small mourning dove. But dove hunting has been really good in a lot of areas. Jerry Cross, old buddy, yeah. Jerry Carl Byer was there, Craig Lucker, the usual suspects. Drew, my grandnephew. You can't leave Drew. You can't leave him home. He's going to find a way to get out there. My nephew Mike and my brother Bob, we had a great time. Teal hunting. Now, this is a story of two teal hunts. Saturday, I'm on the radio. We got the numbers in from Wildlife and Fisher on the flyover. There were 95,000 in the west, 2,000 on Catahoula, 500 in all of southeast Louisiana. Everybody was discouraged. The people who had done scouting weren't seeing any birds. A lot of people failed to go on that Saturday morning. Those who
all
did.
All your fault.
Well, it was all my fault. Yeah, I kept the teal from coming in. But they had
people from going.
Well, maybe they didn't. I'm here to tell you what I know. And a lot of people that went did better than they expected. A lot of people did very poorly. Ryan Lambert predicted that that little front that was going to move in was going to bring a lot of migrating birds in, and it sure did.
He was going on a limb saying, I'm telling you, they're coming tomorrow. Yeah. How you know that? Is the Ducks Unlimited, Delta Waterfowl, they got satellite
just
images
years
and
years
they know.
Of watching.
He says it happens every year. They show up overnight. Now, they had a good day.
Yeah.
When I was hunting the day before, especially the right field. But we had a better day Sunday. So what he said, I told the guy said, Mr. Gary, he said, these early morning birds are a lot better than it was yesterday. It was slow to get started, mm-hmm. and we shot good. And we didn't shoot good that early that morning, but that's the way it was. He says it does there. My brother Jerry. He planted, he loved to shoot. He went to Iowa, and they got them blinds, they had two blinds, and they killed five of them, they killed their 30 birds before 8 o'clock. It started out slow, But as soon as the sun come up, they started having flights of 10 and 12, and a little bit more, started out with 3 and 4. That's what the guy was trying to tell me. So teal is somewhat different. And to go back and mention a dove, when I was there 2 weeks ago for the duck festival, all these fields are still flooded, by the way. I took some shots for riding down there, going to the blind in the marsh. At, on the landing road, we were headed back, and we're still going through water. So you see some of that on the video. But the fields are still flooded. But I saw a lot of doves, especially those Eurasian doves, on the road on 14 on side of the road. Sunday, I didn't see that. I don't know where the dove, I didn't see them. Well, I didn't see them on the line, I didn't see nowhere. 2 weeks ago, I saw them everywhere. Dove and teal, you don't know when they're gonna show up. They're gonna be there one day and not there the next, especially with all this fresh water. So, well, I'm gonna tell you again on the teal hunt, the Southwest is the best. Right now, got the count by everybody, experts, the reports I'm getting. Delacro, hit miss. I heard some people kill some. Catahoula's the biggest surprise. The water's up, you know, levels that people like. I talked to Blake Swallow. He called me in the morning and said, one of the worst opening days we ever had, okay? Didn't say no more. I sent him the pictures from the Southwest I was getting. Not to tease him, but just to share a report with him. He got blinds all over when it comes to big duck season. He's one of the better people you can call. If you call me or you email me, and I stay up on it the whole time during the season, I'll call and tell you. I'll call Dine. You email me, I'll call Dine and see what is going on in the Southeast. So if you want to keep up with them, the best chances to do it is just listen to all these reports and see what happens. These people give you a report.
And sometimes you just got to go.
Well, like I said, Sunday was a little bit better. David Rapola sent me a picture of his buddy. He killed seven. You know, two of them killed seven. That's a little over half a limit. Mm-hmm. But they killed seven teal at Catahoula.
So. Well, bottom line is you still got some time to do it. More teal are arriving daily. If you had a bad hunt on opening day, don't give up. There's still got a couple more weeks to go. And dove season's been very good, too. The only problem with dove and teal being the first seasons of the year, they're the hardest to hit. Wish we had something that flew a little slower to get warmed up on, and then those dove and teal would be at the end of the season.
I agree with you, the doves. By the way, we ain't showed you. We're going to come back and show you that. You know, at Louisiana Outdoor Writers, and that beautiful shooting club. I won by 7 or 8 targets. You know, and then they started messing with it. They were they were throwing through doubles on purpose, and we're supposed to be report. And bam, bam, I hit. All of a sudden, I'll fire it to the ground and hit it, and then they quit. But I can't duplicate that in the field sometime with dove. And teal, left or right, and when they, like I told you, when they shoot, and I'm back up, and when they go up, they got that 1 second. I put it right on, they die.
So, very good. Get out there and hunt. Make sure you get your licenses and everything else you need to be legal.
And by the way, the first time in my life, I got my license. I mean, my federal stamp on my phone. My grandson had got his. Post office was closed. I realized I'm watching the show. I've been having my license since early in the year, fishing season, June. Do I have my duck stamp? I looked at my wallet, pulled it out, 15, 16, instead of 16, 17. So,
but you almost made the bad boys.
No.
All right, coming up, we're going to talk fishing right here on Paradise, Louisiana.
This is our love. This is our life. This is our home, Louisiana. This is our day. Come what may. This is our
together stone forever alone.
This is our home.
We will remain.
This is our life. This is our home.
This
This is Don Dubuque asking you to join me as a member of the Coastal Conservation Association. For 30 years, CCA has worked in Louisiana to conserve our incredible fisheries, making sure that our fishing is great today and for generations to come. Whether looking out for redfish and specks, eliminating gill nets, building reefs across the coast, or work at the state capitol and in D.C., CCA is doing what's best for the fish and the sport we love so much. Your $30 membership will ensure that this work and our great fishing endures well into the future. Go to CCALouisiana.com and join CCA today.
At Rouse's, we love food as much as you do. That's why it's no surprise our chefs aren't the only cooks who work here. Rouse's butchers know how to select, trim, and cook every cut we sell. Of course, our produce experts are the very best in the field.
And on the field.
And you can always count on our seafood department for the best catch.
Heads up, Brandon.
The best quality and the best price is why the best chefs and cooks
shop and work at Rouse's.
Welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana for our Berkeley Abu Garcia Fishing Report. And Gary, even though a lot of people have been out hunting dove, teal, getting ready for the bow season, small game season, a lot of people are not fishing, but a lot of people are. And those who are fishing saltwater are finding a lot of redfish, all sizes of redfish, from the little pumpkin, beautiful redfish in the clear waters of the marshes, all the way to the big bulls on the outer coastline. Shell Beach, Cocodree, Hopedale, you name a spot, they're catching redfish there.
Yeah, more and more, since I've been doing this show, I noticed that a lot of people, they're not in there just for the meat. They love the action, they love the fighting of bull reds. They like catching fish on top water, and y'all showed that right now. It give you a heart attack. I remember catching redfish this time of year on a Lunkaloo, okay, or a buzzbait. Yep. We used to go back in the marsh and they'd be in that shallow water, you see them. And my cousin Andy, rest his soul, he'd throw that Lunkaloo or that buzzbait and he'd go, maybe coming. And then fish would start trailing toward it and he'd go like the jaw, bump, 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 bump. Then we'd get a strike. It is so much fun fishing those redfish and the jackalbill. Some of the national shows, national people come here, they'll tell you right now, jackalbill, you know, you catch redfish, you catch bass, you catch speckled trout, we're well known for everything. But they fish the jackalbill because of the fight. And believe me, they'll take all your line out. So that's what you want to do, that's where it is. But when people are catching good speckled trout, they're catching all over, they're turning on, they're getting reports from Delacroix, Hopedale, they're still catching trout in those areas. Down in Grand Isle, Tommy Vitrine and them are going out. They're going in the back and they're going in front. They free live shrimp, and when they catch pokies, they're using live pokies. Them trout will come up and hit them pokies, suck them in. So, you know, we've been getting those reports from there. I'm still getting those reports. Big Lake is another place catching fish on top water. It's starting to be real good. Redfish are going crazy. Jared Adams sent me a picture of his group of people. He also sent me some pictures of teal, by the way. Jared Adams, excuse me. Jared Adams is on everything right now. In fact, I'm gonna be making a trip this Wednesday with Jared Adams on a teal hunt down in Thornwell. So all I can say is if you want to catch redfish right now, just like you say, they on Big Lake from the southwest all the way to southeast.
And as far as freshwater, Jeff Brule, he's been laid up, poor guy. He hadn't gotten to fish in quite a while. Had a little knee surgery. He'll be back in action pretty soon. Told me there's some pretty steady action in the basin, but if you really want to get into some heavy bass activity, Bayou Black has been the best place lately.
That's also a good place for, I was going to tell you, for succulent. You know, you put it in Bayou Black, you go anywhere, you put it in Amelia, you run down there, the island by, wherever you got, or Copper Saw. All those places you find that water moving. You catch that tide real good, there's a lot of grass, a lot of hyacinths. Sometimes you might get trapped in a canal, but water hyacinths move. So if you know that area, you move and you fish. But I'm gonna still tell you right now, Spillway is hot as a firecracker. You can go catch catfish, you can catch brim, saccalay, and bass.
Well, you know, they had a tournament last week and I hadn't got the results, but it's a unique tournament. And I think you're going to start to see more and more of these. And I really like the idea of a combination bass and redfish tournament. You're catching both species. And you got places like Delacroix particularly where you catch one on one cast and one on another. And there's a lot of areas like that. So that's a good combination trip for this time of
the
year.
That sounds like a winner to me. I might want to get back in the tournament.
There you go.
Now you want to be a partner?
Hey, we'll do it.
We'll do it. That's it.
You work the bass, I'll do the redfish.
Well, North Louisiana, all the lakes in them. I heard of rumors from Bruin, Concordia, St. John. A lot of that rain, every day it muddies up, but as soon as it settles. You know, we talk about all the floods we call about the Florida Pass Rivers, mm-hmm. and all them, and Amy River, Coleman, Bittico Creek, all them. Right now, if you pass through them right now, we had a lot of rain yesterday, and it muddied it up. But that rain wouldn't like the floods. As soon as it clears up, don't forget to float them, wade them, catch them, white spinnerbait, chartreuse and white spinnerbait, white buzzbait.
All right, very good. Well, you saw a lot of pictures, you saw a lot of stories, and we ask you to continue to send them in to us. Gary at Paradise, Louisiana. Don't forget to put where it was, what you caught them on, and the names of the people in your group, and you'll be right here with us on Paradise, Louisiana. We'll see you again next week.